Sinds vorig jaar heeft de kunst- en antiekbeurs Stefaf in Maastricht een afdeling design. Vorig jaar nog apart op een bovenverdieping, nu vol in de zon op de grote beursvloer. Het is een kleine afdeling met 8 handelaren. Philippe Denis uit Brussel is een van de drijvende krachten achter Stefaf Design.
There was never a real section for design, so Mr. Denis has been very much involved in in having this pulled together, and I think it's going to be better also because last year we were upstairs, but we were a little apart. Here it's really the first time that we're really part of the fair as a group, as a section, a real section, and it was a lot of work, so, and for everyone, I think.
But isn't there a big difference between people who are interested in old masters and, on the other hand, design?
Last year we had people, and they were, everything they had was 18th century, and they were just fed up with it. They said, we want to change, we want something completely new, and so there. No, I don't think it's a bad idea. I think it's a very good idea also to have people confronted to something else. Mm-hmm. Because sometimes when you like something, you're always attracted to the same things. And here, you see something different and, okay, it opens up maybe a new world, I don't know.
De catering op de afdeling design is ook aangepast. Geen broodjes of kopjes soep, maar sushi. Een van de topstukken in de stand van Philippe Denis uit Brussel is een piano van de Deense ontwerper Paul Henningsen.
Well, this is a special work of art because, first of all, it's from Paul Henningsen, who is a very famous designer, but who is more known, I would say, for the lights he's been producing and designing. Like, for example, those wonderful pieces that were produced for the Aarhus University in Denmark. And this is a special piece that was commissioned for supposedly a banker for his wife. It was a present to his wife who was interested in jazz. And we're talking about 1931, which was a period when jazz was emerging. And we're also talking about the fact that it was a very new concept for using very specific new material.
Where did you find it?
Mr. Denis found it, and this is normally something we're not talking about. You know, we're finding with private people, we're finding on auction, so it depends. But here, I would prefer not to answer.
Okay. And what's the price of this?
We're talking 200,000 euros.
Why? Is it worth 200,000 euros?
Well, I would guess because it's not that easy to find and there are not that many pieces that were made. On top of it, it's in a very, very good condition. So it's worth it. Okay. It's really a collection piece. You don't buy these pieces for learning piano or just there you go for a Steinway or whatever. But this is really a collection piece.
And you can play on it still?
Yes, obviously, yes, it was checked before we came here, and it's perfectly playable.